Dear student, we have completed our first chapter, solid state. All right. Now we are in our chapter number 2, solution. Here we will start our chapter number 2, solution today. What is solution? So first question rise in our mind. It is a liquid. No, wrong. બધાના મગજમાં એવું આવે કે સોલ્યુશન એટલે કે લિક્વિડ જ હોય. નો, સોલ્યુશન શુડ બી સોલિડ, લિક્વિડ અધરવાઇઝ ગેસ. સોલ્યુશન છે લિક્વિડ પણ હોઈ શકે, સોલિડ પણ હોઈ શકે અને ગેસ પણ હોઈ શકે. ઓલમોસ્ટ ઓલ પ્રોસેસ ઇન બોડી અકર ઇન સમ કાઇન્ડ ઓફ લિક્વિડ સોલ્યુશન. આપણા બોડીની અંદર કેમિકલ રિએક્શન અકર થાય છે, ઇટ ઇઝ સમ કાઇન્ડ ઓફ લિક્વિડ સોલ્યુશન. આપણા બોડીમાં કેટલાક લિક્વિડ સોલ્યુશન દ્વારા થાય છે. બાય યસ, એકચ્યુઅલી વી આર ડ્રિંકિંગ વોટર, થિંક અબાઉટ ઇટ, ઇટ ઇઝ પ્યોર? નો, 100% નોટ પ્યોર. We are drinking water. It contains some salt, ions present into it. In rare case, we are using 100% substances. Actually, water is a mixture of having some salt. So, in the solution, there are two major parts. એટલે કોઈ પણ સોલ્યુશનમાં મુખ્ય બે પાર્ટ હોય છે. One of them we are calling a solvent. So water is our solvent, and added NaCl into it is our solute. So major part of our solution is the solvent, and minor part ઓછો હોય તે solute હોય છે. બેનો ટોટલ એટલે કે સોલ્યુશન, એન્ડ ઇટ ઇઝ અ મિક્સચર. સોલ્યુશન ઇઝ અ મિક્સચર, યસ, નોટ એ કમ્પાઉન્ડ. ટુ ઓર મોર ધેન ટુ કોમ્પોનન્ટ્સ આર કમ્બાઇન્સ વિથ ઈચ અધર, બટ ઇટ મેન્ટેન ઇટ્સ ઓરિજિનલ પ્રોપર્ટી. એટલે તમે મીઠું પાણી નાખીને પીવો છો, તમને વોટરનો ટેસ્ટ પણ આવે છે. વોટર એકચ્યુઅલી ટેસ્ટલેસ, બટ સમજવાની વાત છે. વોટર અને NaCl બેયનો પ્રોપર્ટી છે, એ મેન્ટેન કરશે. સો દેટ ઇઝ અ મિક્સચર. ઇન નોર્મલ લાઈફ વી ઓલરેડી કમ એક્રોસ પ્યોર સબસ્ટેન્સીસ. મોસ્ટ ઓફ ધીઝ આર મિક્સચર્સ કન્ટેનિંગ ટુ ઓર મોર પ્યોર સબસ્ટેન્સીસ. એટલે સોલ્યુશન છે એ બે કે બે કરતા વધારે સબસ્ટન્સનો એક મિક્સચર છે. મિક્સચરનો મિનિંગ થાય ઇટ કાન્ટ રિએક્ટ વિથ ઈચ અધર. જો તમે HCl વિથ NaOH મિક્સઅપ કરો તો અહીંયા કેમિકલ રિએક્શન થાય છે. સો મિક્સ દેટ ઇઝ નોટ મિક્સચર, ઇટ નોટ શુડ બી રિએક્ટ વિથ ઈચ અધર. એટલે જે સોલ્યુશન છે એના કોમ્પોનન્ટ છે એકબીજા સાથે રિએક્ટિંગ ના હોવા જોઈએ, તો જ એને સોલ્યુશન કહેવાય, મિક્સચર કહેવાય. સો ધ યુટિલિટી ઓર ઇમ્પોર્ટન્સ ઇન લાઈફ ડિપેન્ડ્સ ઓન ધેર કોમ્પોઝિશન. હવે આપણા યમન બીંગ માટે એનું કોમ્પોઝિશન બહુ ઇમ્પોર્ટન્ટ હોય છે. ફોર એક્ઝામ્પલ, પ્રોપર્ટી ઓફ બ્રાસ, મિક્સચર ઓફ કોપર એન્ડ ઝિંક, યસ, ઇટ ઇઝ અ સોલિડ સોલ્યુશન. બ્રાસ ઇન ગુજરાતી વી આર કોલિંગ પિત્તળ. બ્રાસ ઇઝ અ મિક્સચર ઓફ ટુ મેટલ, ઝિંક એન્ડ કોપર. વી કાન્ટ સી બાય અવર નીટ આઈસ બર્થ, બટ પ્રોપર્ટી ઓફ બોથ એલિમેન્ટ ઇઝ મેન્ટેન એઝ ઇટ ઇઝ રિમેન કોન્સ્ટન્ટ. હાઉ કેન વી મેક? First, we have to take some piece of copper and zinc. Then we have to melt both, and after melting we have to mix up, and we are cool down. When we cool down that mixture, so it gives a brass. So both we can't appear by our naked eyes. So it is homogeneous mixture. NaCl, when we add into water, NaCl water mana ki liyo. तमने NaCl टेस्ट आपे तो NaCl वाटर में जोई ना सकता है, so that is homogeneous mixture. are quite different from those of German silver. In German silver there are three metals: copper, zinc and nickel. It is a mixture of copper, zinc and nickel. Or bronze. Everybody knows about bronze medal. In the bronze medal, it is mixture of copper and tin, Cu plus Sn. Then 1 ppm, 1 parts per million. At 1 million means 10 lakh. How much part? Suppose one part is present in 10 lakh part. So it is 1 ppm Ky. So fluoride is present in our drinking water. It is very helpful to our teeth. Water prevent teeth decay. એટલે આપણા દાંતને સળતા અટકાવે છે. 1 ppm fluoride is present in our drinking water. Why? Amount of the fluoride is more than 1 ppm. Suppose it is 1.5 ppm causes the tooth to become mottled and high concentrated of fluoride. એટલે તમારો દાંત છે એમાં કથાઈ ડાઘા થઈ જાય કે સડી જાય છે. And more than 1.5 ppm it is poisonous. It a poison bani jaye. For example, sodium fluoride, underline it, it is your MCQ. Sodium fluoride used is as a rat poison. Undar ne marvani dawa ma sodium fluoride we are using. Intravenous injections are always dissolved in water. Apne hospital jaye when we go to the hospital for injection, so concentration of inside our body of the blood and concentration of the injection which is made into water, doctor makes a injection into water, so it maintain concentration similar with our concentration of the blood plasma. So જો બેની કોન્સન્ટ્રેશન સેમ ના હોય તો સો બ્લડ વિલ બી કોન્ટ્રેક્ટેડ, અધરવાઇઝ બ્લડ વિલ બી મોર કોન્સન્ટ્રેટેડ, અધરવાઇઝ લેસ કોન્સન્ટ્રેટેડ. સો ઇટ ઇઝ હાર્મફુલ ટુ અવર બોડી. ઇન ધીસ યુનિટ વી વિલ કન્સિડર મોસ્ટલી લિક્વિડ સોલ્યુશન. યસ, એકચ્યુઅલી સોલ્યુશન્સ આર મેઇન થ્રી ટાઈપ: સોલિડ સોલ્યુશન, liquid solution. Now store in your mind, solution is a mixture, it is homogeneous mixture, and there are three type of solutions: liquid, solid and gaseous. But in this chapter we will consider mostly liquid solution and their formation. This will be followed by studying the properties of the solution. And apparently this will be followed by studying and property of the solution, like vapor pressure. Yes sir, we will discuss about vapor pressure of the solution, some qualitative properties in this chapter, like elevation in boiling point, decreasing in boiling point, elevation in boiling point, freezing point, that are qualitative properties. We will begin this type of solution and various alternative with the concentration of solute can be expressed in liquid solution. So in this chapter we will discuss only about liquid solution, but we will also discuss about types of solutions. So now come to the point, types of solutions. Introduction of the chapter here over. Now we are in types of solution. This one is the definition. Solutions are homogeneous mixture of two or more than two components. Homogeneous means after mixing two component we can't see both separately by our neat eyes, that is called a homogeneous mixture. When we take sodium chloride with water, so what happens there? NaCl dissolves into water and it makes a solution, and we are calling aqueous solution of NaCl. અને આપણે મીઠાનું સોલ્યુશન કહીએ એને સેલો સોલ્યુશન કહેશું, અને વોટરમાં ડિઝોલ્વ છે સો ઇટ ઇઝ એક્વિયસ સોલ્યુશન. હિયર વાય NaCl ઇઝ નોટ રિએક્ટિંગ વિથ વોટર, ઓનલી ડિઝોલ્વ્સ ઇન ટુ વોટર. અહીંયા તે વોટર સાથે રિએક્ટ નહીં કરે, ઓનલી ડિઝોલ્વ થાય છે, સો ઇટ ઇઝ સોલ્યુશન. જો HCl હોય તો દેટ ઇઝ નોટ સોલ્યુશન. વાય NaOH ઇઝ રિએક્ટિંગ વિથ HCl. So that mixture is not a solution, not a solution. Understood? Here, homogeneous means we can't see by our naked eyes, but we get the taste of NaCl when we drink up water like this. By homogeneous mixture, we mean that its composition and properties are uniform throughout the mixture. And akha ટોટલી મિક્સચરમાં બધી જગ્યાએ એનું કમ્પોઝિશન એન્ડ પ્રોપર્ટી સેમ હોય. અહીંથી એક ચમચી લઈને ટેસ્ટ લઈને વચ્ચેથી લઈ કે બોટમમાંથી તો ટેસ્ટ NaCl-નો સેમ રહેશે, યુનિફોર્મ. જનરલી કમ્પોનન્ટ દેટ ઇઝ પ્રેઝન્ટ ઇન ધ લાર્જેસ્ટ ક્વોન્ટિટી ઇઝ નોન એઝ સોલ્વન્ટ. વી ડિસ્કસ્ડ હિયર ઇન ધ વોટર NaCl ઇઝ ડિઝોલ્વડ. સો NaCl ઇઝ અ મેજર પાર્ટ. So that is the our solvent, and NaCl is a minor part of our solution, so it should be solute. એટલે solution માં જે વધારે મેક્સિમમ હોય, મેજર પાર્ટ હોય તે સોલ્વેન્ટ છે, અને જે માઇનોર પાર્ટ હોય દેટ ઇઝ અ સોલ્યુટ કહેવાય છે. રિમેમ્બર, solvent should be one, but solute should be more than one. How? I am giving you. We are drinking in our house lemon juice. In lemon juice, for making lemon juice, we are taking water into pot. Then we are adding some amount of NaCl, lemon, juice of lemon, sugar, and some flavors adding into water. So major part is the water. So solvent is one, but these are solutes. So solutes should be more than one, but solvent is always one. But in this chapter we will discuss about only binary solutions. Binary means only two component present in the solution, one of solute and one of solvent. Largest quantity is known as the solvent. Solvent determines the physical state in the which solution exists. One or more component present in the solution other than solvent are called solutes. Now solution, type of solution depends upon type of solvent. If our solvent is liquid, so it gives liquid solution. If our solvent is a solid, so it gives a solid solution. If our solvent is a gas, so it gives a gaseous solution. In this unit, we shall consider only binary solution. We will discuss about only binary, only two component having a solution. We will discuss about only binary solutions. And now Here there are total three type of solution, but total nine, main three: gaseous solution, liquid solution, and solid solution. Type of these solutions on the physical state, on the basis of physical state of the solvent. If our solvent, you can see in your table 2.1, if our solvent is gaseous, then it should be gas, it gives gaseous solution. If our solvent is liquid, then it gives a liquid solution. If our solvent is a solid, so it gives a solid solution. In the gaseous solvent, solute is also gas, is dissolved, mixed up. So this type of solution is called gas into gas. It means gas is mixed in a gas, mixture of oxygen and nitrogen. Yes, in our air, 20% of oxygen and 78% is dinitrogen. So now tell me, here nitrogen bears like a solvent, major part. Oxygen is minor part, both are gas. And mix up with each other, so it gives gaseous solution, gas into gas. Now liquid into gas. Yes, our solute is liquid, which is mixed up in a gas. Chloroform is a liquid mixed with nitrogen gas. So nitrogen is gas, is major part. The nitrogen gas ma chloroform mix up thai jai, so gives a liquid into gas. Now solid into gas. Some solid particles are present in the gas. Camphor, it means kapur. When we take kapur, camphor, and open into nitrogen air, so particles of the camphor solid will be spreaded into the nitrogen gas. So solid particles present into gas, so that is called solid into gas. Now liquid solution. Why? Our solvent is liquid, so it is liquid solution. So first one is gas into liquid. Oxygen gas is dissolved into water. Yes, oxygen dissolves into water, but it's not reacting with water, so it is mixture, so it is solution. Gas into liquid type of solution. Another example I am giving you, we are drinking soda water. Yes, there is a carbon dioxide is dissolved into water. Carbon dioxide, when we dissolves into water, so it gives a soda water. Here oxygen is dissolved into water. So gas into liquid, so it is a, yes, in our sea water, in our drinking water, in every kind of water, very less amount of oxygen is present, it is dissolved. Now liquid into liquid. Yes, both are liquid. Ethanol dissolved in water. If ethanol is less and water is more, so this one is a solvent, this one solute. Sometimes ethanol, when we take more and water less, then ethanol will be solvent and water will be solute. Suppose both are 50%, then anyone we can call as a solute and as a solvent. Now third one of the liquid, solid into liquid. Yeah, there are many examples. Aqueous solution of glucose. The glucose dissolved into water. Glucose is a powder. When we dissolve into water, so it mix up with water. Aqueous solution of sodium chloride. aqueous solution of glucose of sugar. Now last one, solid solution. Yes, whenever our solvent is in solid state, so it should be solid solution. Gas into solid. Solution of hydrogen in palladium. When we take palladium metal, so molecules of hydrogen will be absorbed over it. So our palladium metal is a solid, which is solid, solvent, and gas is a solute with less amount on its surface. So gas into solid. Now liquid into solid. We know mercury is liquid. Sodium at room temperature is a solid, sodium metal. When we mix both, here amount of mercury is less, so it is solute, and amount of sodium is high, so liquid into solid, and that mixture is also called amalgam. Generally, amalgam word we are using whenever mixture of the metal, and in the mixture one of the metal should be mercury, so word we are using amalgam. Solid into solid. Yes, both are solid. Copper dissolved in gold for the making our household ornament. In the aurum, pure aurum is very soft. For the hardness of the aurum, very soft, we are adding some copper metal for giving the hardness, to get the proper shape of the ornament. We are adding some copper. So how can we mix up? I told you, first we have to take some amount of copper and crust of aurum. We have to melt both. Then in molten state we are mixing, then we are cooling, so we get some mixture, solid into solid. Both mix up with each other, but both not reacting with each other. So there are total 9 types of the solution, and main are 3. Expressing concentration of solution. Yes, sir. What is actually concentration? First, we will take common general example. We are taking 3 glass of water having same volume. In the first glass we added 1 teaspoon of NaCl, in second 2, in third 3. So tell me which one is more sour. By टेस्ट कई वधारे खारू लागशे. थर्ड वन, नेचुरली हियर एडेड सोल्यूट इज लेस, हियर मोर, हियर मैक्सिमम. सो दिस वन इज मोर कॉन्सेंट्रेटेड एंड दिस वन इज अ लेस कॉन्सेंट्रेटेड. बट दिस इज नॉट अ प्रॉपर वे टू डिस्क्राइब. इन रेफरेंस वी आर सेइंग this one is mild, this one is strong, but this one is concentrated with reference to these two. But when we take 5 teaspoon of NaCl into water, so it should be more concentrated, this one should be less. So this one is not a proper method. Composition of a solution can be described by expressing its concentration. Composition of a solution. Water ma kitlu amount solute ni dissolve che, that is concentration. The latter can be expressed either qualitatively or quantitatively. Qualitatively or quantitatively. For example, qualitatively we can say that the solution is dilute. Relatively, very small quantity of solute present. So we are calling dilute solution. Or it is concentrated, means relatively very large quantity of solute. But in real life, this kind of description can add to lot of confusion. That ana reference ma jo hai to more concentrated che. Ana reference ma jo hai to less concentrated che. But in real life, this description can add to the lots of confusion, and thus the need for a quantitative description of the solution. Concentration che, ane represent karwani many methods che. Some of them we discuss in standard 11. Molarity, normality, we discussed them. These are several ways, and another ways of the representation of concentration are given here. These are several ways by which we can describe the concentration of the solution quantitatively. Mass percent, yes sir. Weight by weight. Store in your mind, what is the mass percentage? First thing, percentage should be reference to 100. In the 100 part, out of 100 part, how much part of solute present? That is called a percentage. Percentage che reference to 100 hoy, એટલે 100 part mathi how much part of solute che, that is a mass percent. I am giving example. In 200 gram solution, 200 gram solution ma suppose 20 gram solute che, so 100 gram how much che? So 100 into 20 upon 200. So you can see it gives 10%. Like reference to 100, how much? 500 gram atla gram che, to 100 ma ketla. In 200 gram solute is 20 gram, so 100 gram how much? It gives percentage. Yes, this one is simple formula. And store in your mind. This percentage is of a solute, not of a solvent. And a formula par thi je percentage malse is solute na malse, not of solvent. Ena base thi jo mass of a solute, mass of the component in the solution, the component of the solution, the solute upon total mass. This one, total mass of the solution multiply by 100. Now percentage weight by weight never depends upon temperature. Our concentration check never changes with temperature. Temperature change thai, so our concentration method change nahi thai. This method is not tough depending upon temperature. Ka? टेम्परेचर चेंज थाय तो वेट थोड़ा चेंज थाय, वॉल्यूम चेंज थाय. हियर अवर सॉल्यूट इज इन ग्राम एंड सॉल्वेंट इज आल्सो इन ग्राम, सो ग्राम नेवर चेंजेस विथ चेंजिंग इन टेम्परेचर, सो इट रिमेन्स कॉन्स्टेंट. सो मास ऑफ कंपोनेंट इन द सॉल्यूट सॉल्यूशन अपॉन टोटल मास इन 200. For example, if a solution is described by 10% glucose in water, yes, 10% glucose in water, it means 10 gram glucose. So it is our solute, and remaining 90 gram water is our solvent. And total of both solution is 100. 10% glucose solution in water by weight, by mass. It means 10 gram of glucose, which is solute, and 90 gram remaining water is solvent, and total 100. Concentration described by mass percent is commonly used in industrial chemical application. Industries ની અંદર જે chemical reaction થાય એમાં આ method વધારે use થાય છે. For example, commercial bleaching solution contain 3.62 mass. Mass percent આવે એટલે weight by weight. Store in your mind. Mass percent આવે always weight by weight. 3.62 means 3.62% weight by weight. 3.62 gram sodium hypochlorite, which is solute, and remaining 100 minus 3.62. So 96.38 gram of the water. This is our solvent, and total of it 100. This method is not depending upon temperature. Now come to the next volume percentage. Yes sir, what is volume percentage? Means a solute in milliliter and solvent also in milliliter. Volume percent. Percent should be always reference to 100. 100 part ma, suppose 100 milli, 100 gram, 100 milli. In 100 milli, how much milli of solute is present? That is the percentage of solute in a volume. Suppose 500 milli solution contains 50 milli of a solute. So in 100 milli solution, it is how much? So it gives a percentage of the solute. So 50 into 100 upon 500. So it will be 10. So volume of the component, 50 solute, and now 100, and total volume of the solution. Think about this method depends upon temperature of the concentration. Yes sir, volume of the solution always depends upon temperature. Yes, so this method, this quantity depending upon temperature. Both are in liquid. When we increase the temperature, so volume will be increases. So pela atlu volume hatu. Chare weight by weight alag avse. Have temperature increase thai, volume increase thai. So weight by weight, temperature increase thai, ale concentration decrease thai. Inverse, temperature decrease thai, to volume decrease thai jai, and concentration increase thai jai. Next, for example, 10% ethanol solution in water means that 10 milli of ethanol is dissolved in water, such that total volume of the solution is 100 milli. 10% ethanol into water means 10 milli ethanol is present in 90 milli water. So total will be 100 milli. Ethanol is our solute. Water is our solvent, where 100 milli is our solution. So with reference to 100, it is 10 part. So 10%. This percentage from the formula is of a solute Once again, I am telling you, it is not of this solvent. For getting percentage of solvent 10, subtract from the 100, so it will be 90. Solution containing liquid are commonly expressed in this unit. Solution containing liquid commonly, GRM, solution liquid hoy, dissolved component liquid hoy, tane volume by volume represent tha. For example, 35% volume by volume solution of ethylene glycol is antifreeze. What is ethylene glycol? Yes, this one. Apni 4 wheel ma radiator hoy chhe. There is radiator in our 4 wheels. There is a fan which is moving into the water. So at the hill station, in the cold countries, water inside the radiator freezes at 0 degree. But in some countries, temperature is less than 0. So car will be never start in the morning. So on those area, we are adding in the radiator ethylene glycol. So when mix up ethylene glycol with water, so freezing point will be lower and it is -17.6. Pehla pure water 0 degree ice bani jato tu, ethylene glycol add karwa thi -17.6 degree ice ban se. So 35% we are using, it means 35 milli of ethylene glycol and 65 milli of water. And temperature in Kelvin 255.4. Now mass by volume. Mass by volume. Weight by volume. In other words, the solute in gram. Solution in milliliter. Multiply by 100. It gives the weight by volume. Percentage weight by volume means solute in gram into 100 divided by solution in milliliter. How much gram is present in 100 milli solution? That is the percentage mass by volume. This physical quantity also depends upon temperature. Now store in your mind. Whenever volume comes in our formula, so always it depends upon temperature. Mass never changes with temperature, but volume changes with temperature. So this physical quantity also depends upon temperature. Now another way, the formula for that mass of solute upon volume of solution in milliliter multiply by 100, this one in gram. Now ppm, what is ppm? Yes, parts per million. 1 million means 10 lakh. Yes, out of 10 lakh parts, how much part of solute present? That is the ppm. Out of 10 lakh part, only one part is present, so it is 1 ppm. At 10 raised to 6 part ma, 8 part of the 1 ppm. 10 raised to 6 part ma, 2 part of the 2 ppm. Like a percentage. 100 part ma, 2 part of the 2%. 100 part ma, 5 part of the 5%, like this. 10 lakh part, ma 1 part of the 1 ppm. This method of concentration we are using whenever our solute is very trace, very less amount present. Trace quantity. It is convenient to express concentration in part per million. n is defined as the number of part of the components solute, part of the component part solute, and total number of part of the solution, and multiply by 10^6. टोटल पार्ट 10^15 छे, एमा 10^2 पार्ट छे, अ सॉल्यूशन ना टोटल पार्ट सपोज 10^15, एमा 10^2 पार्ट छे, तो 10^6 आउ मच छे, એટલે 10 લાખ માં કેટલા, ધેટ ઇઝ પીપીએમ, સો 10^6 ઇનટુ 10^2 અપોન 10^15 ઇટ ઇઝ પીપીએમ. 10^6 here common, here number of parts of the component એટલે સોલ્યુટ, 10^15 એટલે ટોટલ પાર્ટ ઓફ ધ સોલ્યુશન. યસ, લાઈક પર્સન્ટેજ પીપીએમ ઓલ્સો ઇન 3 વે વી કેન રિપ્રેઝેન્ટ વેન અ સોલ્યુટ ઇઝ પ્રેઝન્ટ ઇન ટ્રેસ ક્વોન્ટિટી. આઈ એમ ટોકિંગ અબાઉટ pollution in air, impurities in the drinking water, it is very less, khub j less, ochu hoy, to e ppm ma batavama aave chhe. As in the case of percentage, concentration in part per million can be expressed as mass to mass, volume to volume, we discussed percentage in general, jem percentage mass to mass, weight by weight hoy, percentage volume by volume હોય, અને percentage weight by volume હોય, એ જ રીતે as in the case percentage નીચેમાં, so ppm weight by weight, mass to mass, mass to mass ppm means mass of a solute in gram upon total mass of a solution in gram into 10^6. This one gives mass to mass ppm. Now volume to volume ppm is equal to volume of a solute in milli, volume of solution in milli, and 10^6. Understood? Now third one is mass to volume. So how can mass to volume, mass to volume ppm means mass of a solute in a gram upon total volume in milliliter of a solution into 10^6. Mass of solute in gram upon total volume of solution in milliliter, and 10^6 it gives so we can represent by three ways our ppm. Now understood, ppm means how much part out of 10^6 part. 10^6 means 10 lakh, 10 lakh means 1 million, 1 million part ma how much part present, that is called the ppm. As in the case of, yes, we discussed, a liter of sea water which weighs 1030 gram, 8 liter sea water lay samudranu pani contains a mass of 10306 gram, about 6 × 10^-3 gram dissolved oxygen, such a small concentration is also expressed 5.8 gram per 10^6. 10^6 એટલે 1 मिलियन ग्राम में 10 लाख ग्राम में 5.8 ग्राम था, એટલે 5.8 ppm કહેવાય. નાઉ લિસન હિયર, માસ ટુ માસ ppm, સો માસ ઓફ સોલ્યુટ એટલે ઓક્સિજન નું માસ, માસ ટુ માસ ppm ઇઝ ઇક્વલ ટુ માસ ઓફ સોલ્યુટ 10 ગ્રામ અપોન मास ऑफ सॉल्यूशन इन ग्राम इनटू 10^6. सो मास ऑफ सॉल्यूट इज 6 इनटू 10^-3 मल्टीप्लाई बाय 10^6 एंड मास ऑफ सॉल्यूशन 1030 माइनस 3 इज प्लस 6 कट थाय 6 इनटू 10^3 એટલે 6000 divide by 1030, so it is 5.8 ppm. આનો મીનિંગ એ થાય કે 10^6 ગ્રામ હોય તેમાં 5.8 ગ્રામ ઓક્સિજન પ્રેઝન્ટ છે. ધ કોન્સન્ટ્રેશન ઓફ પોલ્યુટન્ટ્સ ઇન વોટર ઓર એટમોસ્ફિયર, એટમોસ્ફિયર નું પોલ્યુશન, વોટર નું પોલ્યુશન એ રીતે ppm માં રિપ્રેઝેન્ટ થાય છે, એક્સપ્રેસ્ડ, એન્ડ ઇટ ઇઝ ઓલ્સો એક્સપ્રેસ ઇન માઇક્રોગ્રામ પર મિલીલીટર. ઇન 1 મિલીલીટર હાઉ મચ માઇક્રોગ્રામ ઇઝ પ્રેઝન્ટ, વિચ ઇઝ ઓલ્સો ગિવ્સ. નાઉ આઈ હોપ એવરીબડી અન્ડરસ્ટુડ. બાય, ટેક કેર, વી વિલ મીટ ઇન અવર નેક્સ્ટ લેક્ચર. ડૂ યોર હોમવર્ક રેગ્યુલરલી.